My name is Troy Reed, producer and director of about 7 to 10 documentaries that I did on different street legends across the country and different other like drug kingpins. First and foremost, I want to extend an apology to Richard Porter, Richard Porter's sister Patricia Porter, Richard Porter's kids, his family, his friends, admirers, and anybody that supported Richard Porter. The reason that I'm doing this video is for the mere simple fact that something was texted to me last week that was sitting on YouTube, which was a video of me doing the Outpost story, which was a raw cut of a small version of what I was doing with the Outpost story. It is something that in a million years, I would never want to be seen by the public in that form, by Richard Porter's family, friends, kids, sister, or anybody in that form. It is very distasteful and heartbreaking to them and to me. And I would publicly like to extend this apology because it's something that I know it probably, I'm sure, has caused them, you know, heartache, as it's caused me heartache and disappointment. It's just distasteful for something that I would personally never want to be seen in this raw form. As a director, it's what we call when you put down raw footage and you start lining it up to tell a story. And this is what, unfortunately, a predator who was preying on this video footage that happened to get leaked or happened to get, you know, jacked from a website called Vimeo, which directors use to actually share large files of video footage. And this is where this was actually taken from. This is a project that I worked on for over 10 years, and I started producing for the last 2 years. Because I actually didn't have all of the elements that I needed in the last year, I put the project down. And that's why it was just sitting dormant on this website for somebody to do what they did. You know, it's something that I actually, you need a couple of different dynamics to actually do. I went to AZ and I sat with him, showed him some of it to see if he'd be interested in participating. And at first he was, and later he actually declined. So without him, you know, Patricia Porter, I got word that she's something that she would never participate in, which is totally understandable that she would never participate in this video. You know, I actually put the project down for a little while to work on other things that I was doing. But to see something that just in its raw form is very, very disappointing that I would not have want the public to see, the family to see, no one to see. And for that reason right there, I am going to now put out what I would call my cut of a small version to address the outcome of that interview, which is totally, totally taken the wrong way, seen in the wrong light. And, you know, it's just not something distasteful that I don't want the world to see in that form. So I will announce, you know, November 24th or November 28th, you will see the rest of this interview and the rest of some of the other interview that I was actually working on. I will no longer put this out in the total form that it was going to come out in. I'm just going to show the director's cut, my cut of what I choose and want to show you guys so that you can see, you know, the outcome of the finished version of this doc, of this film, and of this documentary. Once again, I totally apologize to Patricia Porter, Richard Porter's kids, Richard Porter friends, family, admirers, and anybody else, you know, to AZ and just anybody, you know, that this has affected in the wrong way. You know, I've done a number of documentaries and I've always made sure in my whole lifetime to never do one distasteful, you know, to nobody. No dollar, none of that matters. This is something I did in a raw form and it's something I'm always going to do, you know, do it the way it's supposed to be done. It's our culture, it's our history, and it's something that I want to make sure I always tell in the most tasteful way that I could as a producer and director. In this video, you know, also, I would also like to extend an apology to Alpo because he entrusted me to tell his whole story in an entire form, and his story has very damaging elements to it, but it also has where he's very sorrowful for some of the things that he's done. And I was able to document that. I was able to get that. And I was able to pull that out of him. I was able to talk with him about that. And it was some moments, some private moments that he's expressed some things, some arguing, and he was very frustrated with me about questions that I was asking him and prying into it. And where I even took him to go do, you know, some of his interview at. You know, it was a really big tug of war. And I would also like to show the outcome of that tug of war. So, as I said, November 24th, November 28th, you will see the final version of this. You know, follow me, log on to stay abreast and stay, you know, up to date with what's going on. You know, follow me at Troy Reed official page, you know, on Instagram, YouTube, and anything else. And I will post it up. You'll be able to see it and come follow me. And like I said, I've totally apologized. I don't blame this on bloggers. I don't blame this on people posting stuff. You know, it's just something I did not want to get out there in the public, and I did not want people to see. You know, you make projects and you do things for people to admire it, to like it, to love it, you know, and want to see more and see it again. I just truly, truly, honestly did not want nobody to see my work in this form. And for that reason, once again, I apologize. And that's all I would like to say.